Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Today we're gonna do a fun festive vlog all about the pups, because today's vlog is actually sponsored by Good and Fun. They sent me the cutest box full of holiday treats and I'm so excited. I realize I haven't really done like a full-on penny introduction, so today we will do that. We're also taking the pups to go see Santa Claus for our annual picture. We're gonna take some Christmas card photos with their dogs. We're taking Cooper, Penny, and Bolton Skippy. And I also wanted to just tell you guys Penny's story. As you all know, I rescued her about 2 months ago and I never really told you what happened to her before we got her. This is for her first little Christmas with a family. And after all that, because the dogs love to see Santa, they're gonna get lots and lots of good and fun treats. So I'm so excited to get into it. Let's go ahead and get started, Pencil. Also, I started calling Penny Pencil and now that is her name. Look how cute you are, Penny. Look how cute you are. Oh, beautiful, stunning, and smart. Okay, the dogs will legit freak out if they see me open this. So I'm gonna show y'all first. So Good and Fun sent me this bag with all their holiday themed treats, and y'all know how much I love my dogs, but this year they've been just the best dogs ever. I had a baby, I was pregnant for the majority of the year, they were with me through it all, I could cry, and they've just been the best big brothers to Olivia. Penny was rescued back in October and she had quite a terrible life, so this holiday season I want to make it like extra special for all three of them, plus Cooper of course, and I'm just so excited to give her like a true holiday season. So Good and Fun has a ton of holiday treats for your pups, and y'all, they are so cute. So they have these, and I am not even kidding y'all, these are the Bolt's favorite dog treats. Like, he will eat one of these bones till the very end. He is completely obsessed. So this one comes with like a little variety pack. This one is so cute. It comes with a toy at the top and it says nice on one side and naughty at the other one. Ah, I'm so excited to give them this. This might be my favorite though. Look how cute. And if your dogs also have a stocking, because obviously mine do, you can definitely stick a few of these in or just wrap these up and give it to them for Christmas, because I don't want them to feel left out. Look how freaking precious with the bow, and it says to and from. And if you know anyone that's like obsessed with their pups, Good and Fun treats like this would make such a cute little gift. Like, one of my best friends has two dogs that are huge and beautiful and I love them so much. So I'm definitely gonna give her one of these Good and Fun boxes, because look how cute you don't even have to wrap it. And lastly, to complete the cuteness, they sent a cute little stocking and this cutie little ornament. It's like a little paw print and you can write their name right here. I can't, so I'm gonna open one of these up after the Santa pictures so they're rewarded. But we've been taking them every single year and it's always been Skippy and Bolt, because you know we can carry each one. And then 2019 we took Cooper for the first time. That was interesting, I'll show you. And we are not taking Olivia. Olivia is seeing Santa another day, because I truly cannot imagine taking four dogs and a baby to PetSmart. So we're not doing that. Look right here, Skippy. Come on. Okay, y'all, we're back. That was actually super like quick and very cute. I'll show you guys the pictures right here. But now the dogs deserve some Good and Fun treats, because they did really, really good. And Bolt is just right here waiting. He's been smelling them. They're in my desk and he's literally been just walking back and forth like trying to get some. So let's give it to him, because he was actually a very nice boy. Look what mommy has. He's your favorite. Oh, are you excited? Okay, so because Skippy has no teeth, I'm gonna give him this one. I'm just gonna cut it, but here's Bolt's favorite. There you go, bunny. So because Skippy has no teeth, I always cut the bones or the treats for him so he can still enjoy them, because he loves them too. He just usually hides them and then he just starts eating them. It's so funny. And Cooper couldn't come because they had a three dog like max, and We already have a Santa picture with him, but you still get a nice treat, honey. Were you a good boy this year? Always, always a good puppy. Good. He's a good cookie. That's a good cookie. He's done, and he wants more. So I need to put these away. No, you only get one right now. The rest during Christmas.
Hey guys, it is actually the next day, and I thought since this is a festive Christmas theme vlog, I will show you all the decor that we did for our house this year. We had, well, I did, 3 Christmas trees, one for my office, one for Olivia, and one right here. So I wanted to show you guys around, and then I'll go ahead and insert Penny's story. I filmed that yesterday in the car. So let me show you around our house.
We're gonna decorate for Christmas, and you might be thinking, Philo, are you 5? No, but my daughter is 2 months old, so there's my excuse. So this is the situation. I am gonna do 3 Christmas trees this year. And yes, I am excessive, I'm aware. This is super extra. That being said, I always do a very neutral metallics, golds, like champagnes, things like what you're seeing here, just because it's like my house aesthetic. However, deep inside, I love a pink, and you'll know this about me if you watch my channel. And one for me with all the things I like that are colorful, and one for my bebe. And who knew kids' ornaments were so freaking cute? These are the ones that I have so far for my office tree. It's gonna be like very pink and fun. For Olivia, I have just a bunch of colorful like little animals and like fun stuff like piñatas, a tea kettle. I don't know what I'm gonna keep and what I'm gonna return, but so far this is what I have on the return pile, just because I'm not super sure if I like any of these. These are for the big Christmas tree. Most of them are from last year. Okay, so let's do Olivia's tree. I basically kind of like arranged it to see how many ornaments I would need and which ones I liked and which ones I didn't. So this is what I have so far. I think it looks pretty good. I just need to rearrange some of the ornaments, take off all the tags, move the lights a bit, and then add a tree skirt. And I'm also going to run our little robot vacuum. And yeah, I'll update y'all once I kind of figure it out. What do y'all think? Do y'all like it? I know it's very plain when it comes to ornaments, but my plan is for her to just like get one every single year and kind of like decorate it when she's like a little bit older and understands. So that's why I'm leaving it a little plain, but I think it looks super cute. And I definitely need to get either a bigger blanket or an actual tree skirt, because that looks a little dumb, but how cute. Here is my office tree. Most ornaments and like decor, like the little round balls and things like that, are from Target, Hobby Lobby, World Market, and a few different ones are from Anthro. So I'll show you a few. This one is from Anthropology. Their stuff is so overpriced, but just so beautiful. This one is Hobby Lobby. The garland is Hobby Lobby. I have a few fun ones. Taco, that's from Target. This one I think I got at the mall. World Market, the little greenhouse. Got a lot of fun, like alcohol ones. The sushi platter. Got, these are two of my favorites. Actually, all these three are my favorites. So we have a little nursery that I think I showed in a video. It says 2021 at the bottom. It's just beautiful. And then we have the primrose mirror in the mini. Now I have the big one and I just can't deal. It's so pretty. And then the passport with the stamps on the inside. How fun is that? A ton of like pink girly ones. Most of these balls are from Hobby Lobby. I'm currently washing the tree skirt, if anyone's wondering where that is. And then this one I thought would be cuter, but then it was too late to return. It's Anthropology. It's by Anthropology, and it's just like a planter, but to me it just looks like a face. So yeah, that is my tree. I never want to take it down. I love it so much. And then I got these cute little houses from Anthropology as well. They're so pretty. I actually got 4, like all of them, but I only ended up getting 4. The other one got canceled. They're so pretty. They are a little overpriced, but when you see the price of these houses, like on Nordstrom, like similar ones, they're not that bad. So there's a few that are still available, but I just love them. They light up. I think they look so pretty. I'm obsessed with them. These, honestly, y'all, I think I'm gonna return. They're so bad. I like the idea of them. Like, I think they're kind of cute. Tassel boho trees, but the quality is terrible. Obsessed with these little houses. I'll try to link whatever I can find down below. And then here's our little, well, our big tree, the living room one at night. I still have to put, I just still cannot believe I don't have a picture for the 2019 one. For the 2020 one, I have one for our wedding, and then I got one this year that says baby's first Christmas. How pretty is that? My aunt kind of helped me pick out a few things to kind of like make it look more full. It's definitely very cluttered, just like the rest of my house. So at least it's on brand. And then I did these little doggy paw prints last year with Bolt and Skippy. I need to do one for Penny. And I got these from Crate and Barrel. I kind of want to separate them though, because it just says DOF, but basically the O is silver and then the D for Dante and F for me. What else? I didn't get a ton of new ornaments this year. I think I got this one. I love these from Crate and Barrel. I had to add some lights because the middle light of the tree kind of went off and never turned back on. Dante, I asked him to pick out one ornament. He decided to go for this. So, you know, that's fun. And yeah, I don't know, there's so much here. I mean, this is a 2021. I have the Christmas cards coming in, so I'll take one of those. But yeah, this is our tree. I'm currently in the process of wrapping up some gifts, so it looks a little messy. Okay, so now that y'all saw that, I will show you, well, like, tell you guys Penny's story. I will link the rescue down below. They are an amazing rescue, and I know a lot of you love Pomeranians, and they're always rescuing them from horrible, terrible conditions. They have all ages, all kinds, so I highly recommend checking them out. And honestly, y'all, it's better sometimes to check your local rescue than supporting a terrible breeder. Just saying. So let me go ahead and share Penny's story. This is actually Penny's first outing since we got her. Got her from, I don't know if I told you all that. I got her from a Pomeranian rescue here in Houston. I can link it down below because I don't know the name off the top of my head. I think it's called either Pomeranian Squad or Pom Squad. And basically, they really didn't give me much information about her when I first got her. We went to pick her up at a foster's house, and she had some idea about what happened to her. So basically, she was, I don't know if she was a puppy mill dog or just a breeder's dog. I mean, I don't really know the difference, to be honest. But she was only used for breeding for her entire life, and she was kept in a kennel, like a very small kennel, her entire life. So she's always kind of like hiding in furniture or under the bed or somewhere like close. So I actually asked on Instagram if I should get her a kennel to make her feel like safe, since clearly she likes being like that. But something we did not know, because the foster was a woman that lived by herself with like 16 dogs, is that she is terrified of men. Like, she does not trust men. She is scared of their voices. She's scared of like any men. So clearly, me having a husband, that has been a problem. She's really scared of Dante. She's scared of my brother. She's scared of my dad. I'm assuming, from what I heard from the foster, that the breeder was a guy and that she was abused, because she shows like every single sign of abuse, besides like obviously the like terrible trauma of getting the babies taken away from her and living in a kennel and having no love your entire life. I do think he hit her or something, which is super, super sad. So she is learning to trust, and she's also very scared and like skittish with like noises, loud noises, like things like that. She's completely fine with the other dogs. So Skippy and Bolt are completely fine with her. But like I said, the biggest problem that we have is that she's scared of men. So she doesn't really come out much when Dante's home or when like we're in bed or anything like that. She is just like still super shy, so we're trying to work on that. And then the other thing is, because she lived in a kennel, she wasn't potty trained, and she also wasn't leash trained. So, oh, she's falling asleep.
apparently he took really good he took really good care of her coat because it's like super super soft, very shiny, just really pretty. I'm assuming this is something to do with the breeding situation, like he probably needed to show her. However, her under eyes, y'all, were black. They're getting a little better, but they're still pretty gross. So I got some products off Amazon that I've been trying to use on her, and they're definitely a little better, but she's just a poor sweet girl. She's actually super funny. She like jumps, and like I joke that she's like a gymnast. Like she is crazy. She like jumps on our bed, she jumps from like the door like super high up, she like stands on her two legs, but she's just like scared because she had a terrible life for 5 years. So I don't really like blame her for anything she does. It's definitely a little frustrating that she like refuses to trust Dante because he's been nothing but nice to her, but she doesn't know that. So that's Penny's little story. She's been with us I think for almost 2 months, and getting a little better. So we had to basically stuff under our bed so she wouldn't get under there, and then she just started going under the dresser. I actually ordered a new dresser so she won't be able to hide anymore. So we'll see how that goes. And then y'all know we take the dogs on a stroller ride every day. We haven't taken her, number one, because she doesn't fit, and number two, because I'm scared she's gonna freak out. So I wanna try to like start taking her on walks so she sees the world a little, but like we were advised not to like introduce her to so many new things at first. So that's currently what we're dealing with, but she's kind of funny. She's pretty chill for the most part, except like for some reason at night she just comes out and just makes so much noise. And she's been stealing Olivia's pacifiers and eating them. So yeah, that's Penny's story.
So guys, that's everything for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed just a little festive vlog from me and the pups. And definitely subscribe for more. I will be posting more vlogs. I know I've been slacking on those, but I'm excited to share a ton of things with y'all, like this thing that will be in the next one. Anyway, I love you guys so much. Thank you to Good and Fun once again for sponsoring today's vlog. It was a dream, especially for the pups. And I really, really hope you guys are having a happy December and happy holidays. I'll talk to you guys very soon in my next one. Bye.